Brings down. Nachon shechaser osho betalit mpene shekisui ze machniya lev haadam mevi'o lidei yirat shamayim. He says it's correct and the right thing to do to cover your head with the talet, because when a person covers his head with the talet, first of all, it brings a person to hachna'a, brings a person to become humble, and also a person many times is able to concentrate with his tefila, being that again he's not looking anywhere else, his talet is over his head and he's focusing into his tefila. Some say it should be the whole time of tefila. As long as you have the tefillin on, you should cover your head. But minimum, a person should try to make sure that he covers his head during Amidah. If he could, those are the times that a person should at least make sure to do it. Again, it's not me'akev the din of the mitzvah of mitzvah talet. However, it's correct. It's the right thing to do. Umekom akom. Na'anyan halakha. Halakha al-ma'aseh is she'en chiyuv min adin nechasot rosho betalet. It's not an obligation because they man ha'tefila the whole time. Ve'achar she'it'atev ba ke'atifat ishma'ili. Once you did already the atifat at the beginning when you put on the talet, already you did the mitzvah, and therefore you don't have to do it. Ve'achen im choshesh she'kisui ha'rosh betalet yidron olav ra'af. Let's say you're afraid it's going to bother you, it's going to be mafriya because it's going to fall down and you have to pick it up again. And in such a case, the guy doesn't want to do it. So in such a case, Rashai shelo lechasot rosho betalet. He does not have to cover his head with the talit. He brings down, the Gemara says in Kiddushin, that there was a certain Tamid Hacham that was walking around without his head covering, and that meant that he wasn't married. So there's a machloket. Now how to understand that Gemara? It sounds like machloket bin a poskim. If let's say a person is unmarried, does he have to cover his head or not? From that Gemara, some want to bring a proof that we see that it was only a head covering that was meant only for the men that were married. If you weren't married, it sounds like you didn't have to do it. So he wants to bring down that it's across the board, and the Gemara over there in Kiddushin is talking about a totally different head covering. It's not talking about a talit. It's talking about a sudar, which they used to cover their heads with at all the times. So he says, everything that we just mentioned, that a person should cover his head, at least during tefillah, during Amidah, doesn't make a difference if you're married, you're not married, a person should cover his head. And he says, the Ashkenazim, who have the custom that only the married people wear talit, but the little, anyone who's unmarried does not wear talit, only they wear the tzitzit. They have their tzitzit, and that's what they say the mitzvah is. Says that's their minhag. About minhag shelanu by the Sfaradim is that everybody, starting from chinuch, we already trained the kids to put on talet. He says a person could cover his head or should cover his head even before he's married.